Hello and welcome. Today we're going to be talking about the importance of playing things over and over and over again when you're practicing. And particularly, I'm going to focus on scales. Scales are not particularly much fun, but they are an incredibly important building block of our musical development. And I view the learning curve of a brass instrument a bit like a pyramid. The higher you want your pyramid to go, the better and bigger your foundations need to be. And the foundations are very much those things like scales and the other fundamentals of being a brass musician. But today we're going to talk specifically about scales. And when you've learnt these scales, you may have sat down with a book in front of you, and that book may have each individual note you need to play and what fingers you need to put down or where your slide needs to be. And you'll read that off the page and you'll play it, and it's a very cognitive process initially. It's something you have to really think about. Right, that note is C, I need to put these fingers down, or I need to put my slide into a particular place. Next note is D, I need to do this, and so forth. When you get practicing that a little bit better, you'll be able to not have to think so much about each individual step. You may think C, D, F, G, A, B, C. And you may have your fingers so that they're learning the patterns that you need to play and so forth. And once people have learned a couple of scales, they think, right, that's done, let's move on to something else. That is not something that you want to do. You don't want to stop there. And the reason why you don't want to stop there is because there is a part of the brain that deals solely with patterns of movement. And we continue to do things like scales so that we can get that part of the brain programmed with the scale. So it's kind of like learning to tie your shoelaces. When you're young, you learn to tie your shoelaces, you know, you make a little loop and then you put your other hand in the lace and you put it round and under and through and all the rest of it. It's a really cognitive process. But now you've probably done it so often that you do not have to think about any of the steps. You probably don't even have to look to see what you're doing. You can tie your shoes in the dark. You just say, my shoes need to get tied, da-da-da-da-da, done. You don't think about it at all. And that's because the process of tying your shoes is entrenched in the part of the brain that deals with patterns of movements. With scales, we want to insert every single scale that we're going to likely come across, we want that thoroughly installed and embedded in that particular part of the brain. So I can get my cornet or any other particular instrument. I can think, right, I'm going to play a C major scale, or I'm going to play a C sharp major scale, or whatever. And that part of the brain for me is trained, it knows that. I don't have to think about anything whatsoever. I can just play those scales. And that's because I've practiced them over and over again. So if I'm playing a piece of music and I see a fast set of notes and they're playing a scale that I've learned, I don't have to think about anything. I can just play it. And if there's an accidental in that, I only have to think about one thing, and that's the accidental. And so this is why I believe practicing things like scales and arpeggios and the fundamental building blocks, whilst they may be easy, it's a long-term process for us to program the part of the brain that deals with patterns. And then what we have to do is to make our fingers articulate well enough to be able to take care of that. Maybe very well be fine for our brain to know what to do and be able to do it without thinking, but our fingers have to be able to keep up. There are some combinations of fingering that's very difficult to do. First and third to second, for instance, going oscillating between those combinations is quite difficult and quite unnatural to do. And so there's things like that we need to work on and continually strive to get better at. To give an example of this, I've got a cornet here, and I can play most major scales without having to think about them. Don't have to think about the fingering, don't have to think about anything, I can just play them. But there are a couple of scales that I have never bothered to practice or learn very much, and the speed in which I can play those scales is greatly reduced because I just haven't spent enough time practicing them. I know the notes that I need to play, I know the fingering for those notes I need to play, but my brain isn't programmed to operate as fast as possible to play those scales. So let me give you an example. I'll play a bunch of scales that I can play without having to think about it whatsoever, and then I'll play another scale, say F sharp major, which I haven't bothered to learn because I don't ever play in that key signature, or B major, another very uncommon key signature in brass band music, and you'll see the difference in how fast I can play those scales and how accurately. So there we have it, the reason why it's incredibly important to keep practicing things you already know.